see how you look with your...
Well, let's get the veil on.
Oh,
let's
yeah.
Get the veil. Did anybody get it?
No.
Where is it?
In the closet.
Which closet?
My closet.
It's in a bag. It's in a white plastic bag. There's a white plastic bag covering it. It's hanging on a hanger in the closet. Got it?
No.
Yeah.
They changed.
Takes it off, just kind of fluff up on the sides, you know.
Me?
Yeah. Just like that.
I'll get it. Don't worry about that. I'll get it.
Okay, let's see how you look with your bouquet.
Oh! Oh,
maybe we should. No, look at her.
Oh!
Remembrance of childhood.
Oh! Or clam.
Oh gosh, get the tissues again.
You better keep the hanky out. Okay, girl.
Kevin and Janet, I want to welcome you and your families. Many of you have come from quite a distance to be here to share on this day when you begin your life together in marriage. And so we come together to support you in our love and our prayers, and so let us pray. Father, you have made the bond of marriage a holy mystery, a symbol of Christ's love for his church. Hear our prayers tonight for Kevin and Janet. With faith in you and in each other, they pledge their love today. May their lives always bear witness to the reality of that love. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Please be seated now as we hear.
Leading on the mountains, bounding over the hills, my beloved is like a gazelle, like a young stag. See where he stands behind our walls. He looks in at the window. He peers through the lattice. My beloved lifts up his voice. He says to me, come then, my love, my lovely one, come. My dove, hiding in the clefts of the rock, in the coverts of the cliff, show me your face. Let me hear your voice, for your voice is sweet, and your face is beautiful. My beloved is mine, and I am his. He said to me, set me like a seal on your heart, like a seal on your arm, for love is strong as death, jealousy relentless as shield. The flash of it is flash of fire, a flame of the Lord himself. Love no flood can quench, no torrents drown. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
He, Yahweh, is merciful, tender-hearted, slow to anger, very loving, and universally kind. Yahweh's tenderness embraces all creatures.
The Lord is his passion to all his creatures.
Yahweh, all your creatures thank you, all your faithful bless you. Patiently, all creatures look to you to feed them throughout the year.
The Lord is compassion to all his creatures.
Righteousness in all that he does, Yahweh acts only out of love, standing close to all those who invoke him, close to all who invoke Yahweh faithfully.
The Lord is compassion to all his creatures.
From the first letter of Paul to the Corinthians, be ambitious for the higher gifts. I am going to show you a way that is better than any of them. If I have all the eloquence of men or of angels to speak without love, I am simply a gong booming or a simple flesh. If I have the gift of prophecy, understanding all the mysteries there are, and knowing everything, and if I have faith in all its fullness, to move mountains without love, then I am nothing at all. If I give away all that I possess, peace by peace, and if I even let them take my body to burn it, but am without love, it will do me no good whatever. Love is always patient and kind, and is never jealous. Love is never boastful or conceited. It is never rude or selfish. It does not take offense, and is not resentful. Love takes no pleasure in other people's sins, but delights in the truth. It is always ready to excuse, to trust, to hope, and to endure whatever comes. Love does not come to an end. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
He came from Buffalo, even though I was stationed here for 8 years, and I taught Janet in high school. And
Rochester, San Francisco, Pennsylvania, I'm not sure where else we're all coming from. There's a lot of other places. They came here today to witness the beginning of your married life. And I thought I'd like to just start out with something a little bit light today. I'm not going to talk too long, but Janet knows me from school and from church here that I always like to start out with a little joke and something to kind of get people will pick up. And it reminded me of a story of marriage of a young priest who was just ordained. And he really was always very nervous. And whenever he would get into the pulpit, he would actually freeze and forget everything he was to say. So he went to the older priest, the pastor, and the pastor gave him a word of advice. He says, the next time that you get into that pulpit to preach, and you freeze and you can't remember anything, just start thinking of a scripture passage. Think of a passage in Scripture, and then just start off with that passage, and that'll get it going. That'll get it going. So he had his first wedding. Oh, the young bride, just like Janet and Kevin were there, and everybody was looking so beautiful. And the priest got into the pulpit, and he froze. And he just couldn't think of a thing. He just couldn't think of another word to get out of his mouth. And he started thinking of a passage to say, a Scripture passage. And all of a sudden, he said emphatically, Father, Father, forgive them, for they don't know what they're doing. Well, Kevin and Janet, the Lord doesn't have to forgive. forgive you today, because I think both of you know what you're doing. And the Lord, in some special way, has called you together today. And the reason why we're gathered here today is not only in order to witness your marriage, but to support you with our prayers and our love. Marriage, by nature, is sacred. The scriptures tell us that a man leaves his father and mother. He clings to his wife, and the two become one. And today, I think if there's any word that seems to be misunderstood, it's the word love. And your father, Kevin, read St. Paul's letter to the Corinthians, the definition of love. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not jealous. Love does not put on airs. Love is not rude. It's that type of love that lasts forever. And that's the type of love we're praying for both of you today. That love will somehow continue to grow. And it does grow as long as you allow the Lord to touch your love today. I always think that we must believe that you didn't come here by coincidence. It wasn't a coincidence that you came to Shaw Air Force Base. That in God's plan, somehow he called you here. And in God's plan, Janet and you met. Both of you met. And somehow, in his plan, if you allow him to touch that relationship throughout your life, it will continue to grow. There's a story that I always share at weddings. And the story is a story that took place in my own life when I was visiting an aunt and uncle who were celebrating their sober anniversary. And my Uncle John told me the story, and I'm not really sure if it's true, because being an Italian, he had a way of exaggerating things, but this is the story, and it has a real point to it. I was at their celebration of their sober anniversary, and he was telling me that 25 years ago, when they were engaged, they had gone to a park in Buffalo. And my uncle, being a romantic person that he was, he took a penknife and he found a young tree. And he carved a heart on the tree and he put the words, John loves Mary. And now 25 years later, they went back on their silver wedding anniversary to see if they could find their tree. Oh, and they searched and searched and they couldn't find it. And they really felt disappointed thinking that someone had cut down their tree. And as they were about to leave the park, they found it. But it looked a lot different. Because like most of us after 25 years, the trunk gets larger. Like most of us after 25 years, especially if you're in Buffalo, New York, or Rochester, we look a little bit more weather-beaten because of the type of weather. But somehow they knew it was their tree because over the 25 years, as the trunk got larger, so did the heart with the words, John loves Mary. Now what does this have to do with Kevin and Janet? In just a few moments, Kevin and Janet, you will etch on each other's hearts for the rest of your life, Kevin loves Janet. And like the tree that I described, you're both young and a beautiful day that it starts off with. But being realistic, there might be some rain. And if you live up north, there'll be definitely some snow. But somehow I can guarantee you, Kevin and Janet, that your love will continue to grow if you etch one more name on your hearts today. It's the name of Jesus. You have to believe that Jesus brought you together. You have to believe that he somehow is blessing your love and he will be the center of your relationship. St. Paul says, if God is for us, who can be against us? Who can separate us from the love of Jesus Christ? And so today you're asking the Lord in front of this altar to bless your marriage. But not just for today, but forever. And so today you begin that love together. And there's just one other word of advice that I always give. In any relationship, I really believe there's three bones that we need. The first is you have to have a wishbone. You have to have dreams. And as you come together today to begin your life together, I'm sure there's dreams about your future. So that's that wishbone. But the second bone is a backbone. You've got to be strong, because in the days of heaven, there's days when you're going to have to be strong together in order to fulfill those dreams that you have. But the most important bone in any relationship to me is a funny bone. You have to laugh together. And I think oftentimes in relationships, we fail to enjoy each other. We fail somehow to take the beautiful, simple things of life and laugh together. And if you can do that with the Lord blessing it today, your love will never end. Janet and Kevin, today is the first day of the rest of your life. May the rest of your life be as blessed and as beautiful as it is now, as you now take those vows before your family and your friends. God bless you. Come here in this church so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of your family and this community. Christ abundantly blesses your love. He consecrated the both of you in baptism, and now today he enriches and strengthens you by a special sacrament so that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual and lasting fidelity. And so now, in the presence of the church and your family, I ask you to state your intentions. Kevin and Janet, have you come here freely tonight and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage? Will you love and honor each other as husband and wife for the rest of your lives? Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church? Kevin and Janet, since it is your intention to enter this marriage, I ask you to now face each other, to join your hands together, and declare your consent before God and his church. I, Kevin.
I, Kevin.
Take you, Janet.
Take you, Janet.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
I promise.
I promise.
To be true to you.
To be true to you.
In good times.
In good times.
And in bad.
And in bad.
In sickness.
In sickness.
And in health.
And in health.
I will love you.
I will love you.
And I will honor you.
And I will honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
I, Janet. Take you, Kevin.
Take you, Kevin.
To be my husband.
Be my husband.
I promise.
I promise.
To be true to you.
True to you.
In good times.
In good times.
And in bad.
And in bad.
In sickness.
Sickness.
And in health.
And in health.
I will love you.
I will love you.
And I will honor you.
I will honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
Kevin and Janet, you have declared your consent before the church. May the Lord in his goodness strengthen your consent and fill you both with his blessings. What God has just joined together, let no one ever separate. Amen. A ring is a band of gold. It's also a precious metal, and it's a circle. As I bless this ring that they will give to each other, these rings, may they be a sign that their love will never end, just as the circle never ends. May the Lord bless these rings which Janet and Kevin give to each other. May they be a sign of God's love and fidelity and their faithfulness forever. Amen. Janet, take this ring.
Take this ring.
As a sign.
As a sign.
Of my love.
My love.
And fidelity.
And fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit. Kevin, take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. When the celebration, the ceremony began, two candles were lit on the altar representing their own individual lives. Now, Kevin and Janet will come forward and light the candle in the center, reminding them that as these flames mingle into one, they are no longer two but one. But God is joined. Let no one ever separate.
Thank you. Coming down, you've been coming over some serious distances. I want to thank you all for coming and helping Kevin and Janet enjoy their special day together. From now on, they're living as one. They're having fun as one. And they're making little nieces or nephews as one. I can't wait. This is a very special day. Some of you have been able to enjoy this day such as I have. It means a lot to, I'm sure, both sides of the family. It's a special day when we all give each other thanks, especially to God. And we're all very, very pleased to be blessed by Him and the fact that He's given Kevin and Janet this chance to enjoy their life together as one. I have to emphasize that one. They're going to have fun with that one. I would like to ask everybody to raise their glasses now in a toast to Kevin and Janet. May they live their lives together as one and enjoy the rest of their lives having children, being children. It's most important that you be children together. And obeying your parents. Taking brothers and sisters' advice. Letting them borrow the car every once in a while. No, the final more future and much love to Kevin and Janet DC. I'm very proud of you. Thank you very much.
Here.
Are they busy?
Yeah.
At this time, folks, we'd like to invite Mr. and Mrs. Jeruzic and Mr. and Mrs. Deasy to join Mr. and Mrs. Kevin Deasy on the floor. And a little hand for our new bride and groom, folks. And now, ladies, doing a little film break. We'll be ready in just a second. You can do practices. One,
two,
three. Oh, a little rebound shot there.
Good point, Shelby.
Now, guys, I need the single guys. You're not going to get out of this. And for in lack of a drum roll, remember, this is a family affair.
Oh,
So good off
the
folks to do a little shagging. Here you go.
Ain't no thing. band do. Light up the stage and watch it jump like a candle. Dance. So much bigger than boom. I'm killing your brain like a poisonous mushroom. Deadly. When I play a new melody, anything less than the best is a felony. Love it or leave it. You better gain weight. You better get moves out of here. Don't play. If there was a problem, yo, I'll solve it. Check out the good one. I'm DJ Ramon. Yo, so I continue to A1A. Be drunk, I'm a girl for hot women, let's get bikinis. Rock me in love, just gotta let the beanies jealous. I'm on the mouth, keep on my ass. Chain with a gauge and my villain with a knife. Crazy, fill the chunks on the ball. Just like the number, cause the ball ain't ball. Gunshots, raised out like a bell. I grabbed my knife, all I heard was shells. Falling on the concrete real fast. Jumped in my car, slammed on the gas. Bumper to bumper, having a pack. I'm trying to get away from the jack and jack. Police on the scene, you know what I mean?
come look my way. Pretty woman, say you'll stay with me. Cause I need you. I'll treat you out of my way.
Oh,
Once again, we'd like to congratulate Janet and Kevin. Best wishes to you. All the luck in the world.
I'm not doing it.
Party.
right now. Any day now. I'm ready to go to the club.
Shelly's got something on her mind.
Right here.
Look at Shelly.
Huh?
Come on, you whip.
She got something on her mind. Dude.
Oh, come on, this is a good dance.
Yeah, get out of the way.
What?
Yeah, you better get out of the way.
Yeah, you're going to end up in the bush.
Wait, it's another imposter.
Get in. Get that shot
from here. All right, here they come.
Here they come.
Okay, hey.
All right, watch out.
Come on, Michelle, get out of the way.
Michelle, get out of here.
Come on now.
Come on, guys. We're ready.
Funny.
Yeah. Oh, the birds eat out of our hair tomorrow.
I just stand outside. The birds will get it for you right now.
Really?
Thank you.
Look at the birds.
I'll be back.
How are you?
I will.
Yeah.
I'm going to. Make sure you get him in there with you, girl. For everything.
Okay.
We'll stop right.
I'll pay. Turn it into the most important.
We'll see ya.
Okay, babe.
I want to see which way they're heading.
Right. Straight.
No, they're at the stop now.
Turn right.
Well, he's waiting for a while. Well, he's making a right.
Yeah, I told you. Right.
Okay.